Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Welcome to the online class. I am here, your course instructor, Muhammad Waqas, for the course Climate Change, ENS-361. As you know, we had studied the climate, the weather, the difference between climate and weather, the climate system, the impact of climate changes, different natural and anthropogenic sources of the climate change. Today in this lecture we will talk about the climate change profile of Pakistan. Well, before going in deep about the climate change profile, the impacts of climate change on Pakistan, first of all we will discuss the country overview, the geography and climate of Pakistan, the demography, the population statistics, as well as the climate threats to Pakistan. If we talk about the geography and climate, Pakistan extends over an area of 796,000 kilometers square with a great diversity in temperature and precipitation. In the country, the eastern areas of the southern half mainly receive the precipitation through the southwest summer monsoon, that is from June to September, while the northern and western areas of the southern half of the country get rains mainly through the western weather disturbance in the winter, that is from December to March. The summer monsoon accounts for around 60% of the total annual rainfall. And if you talk about the climate varies from arid to semi-arid, where three-fourths of the country receive the rainfall of less than 250 millimeter per annum. However, except in the southern slopes of Himalaya and the sub-mountains regions in the northern region of the country, the annual rainfall range from 760 to 2000 millimeter. If you talk about the northern region includes some of the world's highest mountain peaks, for example the K2, that is 8,611 meter high, and as well as also the northern region include the largest glaciers, include Siachen, that is 70 kilometer long, and Biafo, that is 63 kilometer, as well as these glaciers also feed the Indus River and some of its tributaries. During winter, the temperature in this region drop to as low as minus 50 degrees centigrade and stay around 15 degrees centigrade in the warmest month of May to September. The western and southern segment of the country represent the Indus River Basin Plain and the Balochistan Plateau. The transboundary Indus Basin cover 520,000 kilometers square, or simply we can say 65% of the country total area, including the whole provinces of Punjab, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, most of the central territory, and the eastern part of Balochistan. If we talk about the Indus River further, the Indus Basin irrigation system is the world's largest irrigation system, accounting for 95% of the country total irrigation system. The average rainfall in the Indus Plain is around 230 millimeter. The temperature differences between the upper and lower basin plains are also quietly noticeable. The mean winter temperature, that is from December to February, in the lower plain is 14 degrees centigrade to 20 degrees centigrade, and in the upper plain area it is from 2 degrees centigrade to 23 degrees centigrade. Similarly, during summer, that is from March to June, the mean monthly temperature varies from 42 degrees centigrade to 44 degrees centigrade in the lower plane, while in the upper plane it's ranged from 23 to 49 degrees centigrade. Similarly, if you talk about the Balochistan Plateau, the Balochistan Plateau is a vast wilderness of mountain ranges in the southwest of the country, with the average altitude of about 600 meters. Some seasonal rivers cross this Balochistan Plateau, but most of its northwestern part is a wide expanse of deserts that is similar to the deserts found in the central part of the country, such as Thar and Cholistan. The rainfall in this region is less than 210 millimeter annually, or simply we can say that is less than 20 to 30 millimeter per month. The second one is the population statistics of Pakistan, or simply we can say the demography of Pakistan. Pakistan is the sixth most populous country in the world, with the population size of above 184.5 million, with the current average annual population growth rate of 2%. It is projected to be the fifth most populous country of the world by 2050. The density of population is 231 persons per kilometer square, or with almost 37% of the population residing in the urban area. The current total fertility rate of 3.8% is one of the highest in the Asia Pacific region, while the country holds the second highest out of the school population in the world, which two-thirds are girls. If we talk about the poverty rate, is estimated at $2 per day. Purchasing power parity exceed 50% of the total population, with stark provincial disparities. The southern sub-regions of all provinces are noted for a very high ratio of severe poverty incidences compared to the northern counterparts, except for Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, where the poverty is equal in both sub-regions. This high prevalence of poverty, coupled with the lack of and access to the resources, places the country in the low human development category. And if we ranked it, it's 146 out of 187 country, well below the average human development index value compared to the other South Asian countries. The third one is the climate threats to Pakistan. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, that is IPCC, simply we can say, the fifth assessment report for the Asian regions notes that sensitivity to climate change threats in agriculture dependent economies, for example Pakistan is an agriculture dependent economies, arises from their distinct geography, demographic trends, socio-economic factors, and lack of adaptive capacity that, when taken together, determine the vulnerability profile by continuing a vicious cycle of poverty. The climate change projection of the fifth assessment report for South Asia as a whole show that warming is likely to be above the global mean, and climate change will impact the glacier meltings and precipitation patterns that particularly affect the timing and strengthening of the monsoon rainfall. That is, consequently, this will significantly impact the productivity and efficiency of water-dependent sectors such as agriculture and energy. So this was all about the country overview, that is the geography, the demography, and climate threats to Pakistan. And next presentation, we will talk about the environmental consequences towards Pakistan. Thank you so much, and see you in next class.